Now, I'm about to record a video which is absolute bullshit. Okay, here it is.
He's VB and he lives in Perth, making super videos for all his worth. His channel is great, he's a good mate with Beryl of Feral, so don't hesitate.
G'day, beer lovers. It's our old mate again here, VB.
G'day beer lovers. Today I'm revisiting Elizabeth Quay here in Perth. Haven't been here for a couple of years and there's been a lot more development here now since I last did a video here. It's just come to my attention recently, just by walking around, that this whole place has been developed using occult concepts. Yeah. I'll show you what I mean. You know, you do need a bit of an imagination to understand what I'm trying to say. But see if you can just follow my argument. You probably think that I'm wacko, but alright, come along with me. I'm going to show you why I reckon this whole thing has been developed to somehow harness the energy of the occult. In Greek mythology, there is the story of the River of Styx. Now, the River of Styx is the divide between the earth, this world, and the underworld, which is called Hades. Now, when you die, you catch the ferry across the River of Styx. So you leave this earth to go to Hades. Now, you have to pay the ferryman one coin. If you don't pay the ferryman a coin, you are left on this earth to live eternity as a ghost. So, let's catch the ferry from this place to the underworld, which is Elizabeth Quay.
And when the rain came down, he heard a wild dog howl.
The latest addition to Elizabeth Quay is cruising the Swan River in traditional Venetian gondolas.
And people calling out his name, and dancing bones that jabbered on a mon on the water. And then the ferryman said, there is trouble ahead. So you must pay me now.
Don't do it.
You must pay.
Lovelocks, or love padlocks, are found at Elizabeth Quay outside the bell tower. They are attached to public fixtures to symbolise sweethearts' love for each other. The padlocks are inscribed with the sweethearts' names, and the key is thrown away into the river to symbolise their unbreakable love for each other.
behind me is the Perth Bell Tower. This is situated here at Elizabeth Quay. This was built in the 1980s. Now it contains 18 bells from a church in London. The church is called St. Martin of the Fields. It's in Trafalgar Square. And so the British government donated 18 bells to Australia. It was part of our bicentennial celebrations in 1988. And so this is where the bells of St. Martin's in the Field are now housed.
In the Bible, in the book Genesis 11, the Bible talks about the Babylonians who built the Tower of Babel. They built the Tower of Babel so that it could reach to the heavens, so that the Babylonians could be like God, and they would not need God anymore. The Tower of Babel was called Babel because the word Babel means confusion.
The actual bell tower looks like a magic wand. The way it's pointed up to heaven, up to the sky, it's almost like it's projecting energy. It's drawing energy from above and then channeling that energy down to the key.
The tower in the tarot represents the breaking down of existing forms. When things reach the boiling point and things can no longer exist within confines, the tower will fall. In the tarot, the Wheel of Fortune signals a change of fortune. This may be good or bad, but whichever way the wheel turns, it brings growth and a new phase of life.
Behind me is a statue called First Contact, and it represents what the Aboriginals thought they were seeing when the white man arrived here. And what they saw was a ship, a sailing ship out at sea, and they thought it was a gigantic bird on a canoe. They thought it was a god.
Oh, it's not fair.